without taking much of time, I'll start sharing the screen. Is my screen visible?
Yes, sir. It is visible and you're audible.
Thank you so much. Greetings from JSS Medical College, Mysuru. As Murali was telling, one of the beautiful cities in the country. It was one of the cleanest city for 3 consecutive years sometime back. And my talk today is lifestyle and lifespan. I'll not take much more time than 15 minutes because every one of you are aware about the facts which I'm going to talk to you. I don't have too many data like what Murali showed you, the cross-linking, something beyond COPD in this. What determines our lifespan? Basically, we are born to genetically driven constitution of the body that drives our force of living longer or shorter. Public health system in the region where you are living, nutrition status, infant and childhood. We were aware the fetal origin of adult disease concept, which was there earlier and which is still there. Now, added factor is developmental origin of adult disease. How you behave yourself as a child will decide how you will be healthily, happily living for a longer time as an adult. That is called as developmental origin of adult disease. Several vaccinations to prevent you, protect you from various infections. The lifestyle, it depends on how risky behavior you have. Accidents, we can take away somebody's life too early. NCD burden in the region where we are living, it all is driven by lifestyle, because we call them as lifestyle diseases. We all know the definition of health. I will not indulge in defining that. Spiritual health component is added. And the matter of today's talk will be revolving around health, wellness, illness, which will interplay with your genetics, with which you are born, and the lifestyle which you are indulging in to determine how long, how happily you're going to live on this earth. Having said this, we all know the genesis of diseases are basically pre-constituted by genetic drive and to the parents whom you are born, which will be influenced by the environmental milieu. Infections can creep in, and there could be a genetic driven infection susceptibility. And over and above that, the large cap on which we determine our disease and health will be the lifestyle. The mind, the social aspects, and the spiritual component will order a lot in that direction. We all know about, we call these as lifestyle diseases, and several more are getting added to the list, like high blood pressure, diabetes, obesity, cancer, ischemic heart disease, anxiety, depression, and so on. They are all determined, influenced greatly by the way we live. So what is lifestyle? The lifestyle is the way in which we live and behave in life. And several components are there. I'll just touch upon some of them, which will be altering the lifespan of the individual. The physical activity, the diet, the habits, the sleep, time management, stress management, your attitudes towards the situation, to the people, to yourself, art of giving and happiness will all determine the lifespan, and which are all the components of lifestyle. Dear friends, we all know lifestyle is an important component on this earth when we are dealing with this kind of lifestyle. Several disease components are creeping in, and the lifestyle will augment or modify the progression or the rate of progression of the disease or intensity of the disease. We are all aware this very, very famous statement, and even stated by Swami Vivekananda, you are the sculpture of your body. You can be what you desire to be. It all depends on how you behave and how you design your body. Michelangelo's sculpture, which is there right here in the corner, is a perfect human being's sculpture in terms of symmetry, in terms of hair, in terms of eye, in terms of nose, the skin texture, and so on. If you want to be like that, your lifestyle has to be right. We all know the present day, the physical and emotional health intermingled with time management will put you on stressors, and that will alter your lifestyle. The teamwork and leadership qualities in whatever job you are assigned with will require a lot of lifestyle adjustability, and commitment and work ethic will all put you on whether you can be a scholarly athlete. Each one of these components I'll just touch upon in a few minutes, and the physical activity, whether it is walking, gardening, hiking, dancing, and cycling or swimming, whatever kind of physical activity of 30 minutes a day would help you to put you onto the required physical activity of minimum. If you can lead a little more, it's all right, but don't do too much. And the benefits are very, very evident. All-cause mortality, if you are a good person with exercise of 30 minutes, your all-cause mortality will be down by 30%, and cardiovascular disease by 35%, type 2 diabetes prevention, progression of the disease, and intensity of the disease by 40%, colon cancer by 30%, depression by 30%, hip fracture by 68%, dementia by 30%. What more you need? So you will be living happily for a longer time if you are physically active. And coming to the diet, we all know more movement is happening towards vegetarianism, more movement is happening towards the proper balanced diet for living longer and happily. You need to have those three portions of adequate vegetables to give you fiber, adequate fruits and dairy products and pulses to give you proteins, and moderation and limiting down the carbohydrates, like the Indian high carb diet, which can come down into one-third, 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 to have a balanced diet with a proper micronutrients and macronutrients to keep you healthy and happy for a longer time. Then sleep is one component of lifestyle which is never discussed and most neglected component, both by clinicians as well as by the patients. Individuals, we all know, when we are born on this earth till we die, in the whole lifespan, we spend roughly one-third of our lifespan in sleeping. And we sleep 14 to 17 hours when we are born, between the first 3 months. And when we become adult, we need to sleep about 7 to 9 hours, an average of 8 hours. And present day, as the days are advancing, we sleep less and less. And less sleep will cut down your lifespan. There has been a lot of documented studies, and Mohan Murali will agree with me. He must have seen a lot of OSAs and its implications. As a pulmonologist, sleep is your ticket to good health, which is a very correct statement. 3 hours related to sleep is rest, recovery, and rebuild. We clinicians, we doctors, sleep less and curtail our lifespan. So we need to understand, should not neglect, and we should spend a little more time in listening to a patient about quality and the duration of sleep, and try to help them to have a better sleep, to have a better outcome of the treatment for any disease, whether it is lifestyle related or otherwise. And we all know there are several tips for to sleep well, and these are all well known to all of you. And most common wrong things that we all do knowingly is addicting to the screen, keep watching the TV, and having late night parties and dinner, and to keep watching the cell phone on the bed. And that all should be avoided for a better hygienic sleep. You should stop screen viewing at least 1 hour before. And several sleep wake disorders are there. I'll not delve into that. Murali will agree with me. The OSA is related to so many health problem augmented, excessive tiredness, headaches worsening, migraine worsening, increased accidents proneness, increased insulin resistance, and worsening of diabetes control, higher incidence of stroke, high blood pressure, cardiac problems, and worsened GERD, weight gaining problems, memory problems, are all intermingled with inadequate sleep, and more so in a situation like obstructive sleep apnea. So suggestion is, please look into this quantum of this component of lifestyle, which is very, very important and often neglected. Habits and risky behavior. We all know the mindset, habits, and routines are the building blocks for success towards your wellness goals. Habits are the compound interest of self-improvement. That is what James Clear mentioned. These are all the healthy habits which will keep you healthy for a longer time. A healthy mind and a healthy body will keep you healthy for a longer time. And that has to be mindfulness. Attitude is very, very important. Break bad habits and build good habits, and change your habits, change your life. Help others, get fit, find a new job if you are irritated by the present one, lose weight if it's possible if you are overweight and obese, enjoy the life. Happiness will augment your longevity, quit smoking, drink less, find love, and save money, not for generations, for your comfortable future. With that, you can live longer. We all know about the clinical benefits of yoga, and it is complementary to present therapy. It can help in preventing certain diseases. It improves the general health and helps in rehabilitation. And meditation is about the thing that about meditation is that you become more and more you. And goal of meditation is not to control your thoughts, but it's to stop letting them control you. We need not have a deep meditation capacity like Buddha, who went into deep meditation and enlightened, but at least getting through a trainer, you can get all these benefits in children, all these benefits in adults through meditation. Time management is a very, very important component, because that is the one which will put you into stress. Set goals correctly, prioritize wisely, set a time limit, take breaks between, organize yourself, remove non-essential tasks, and plan ahead. That will help you to keep calm and behave properly in life. And 11 quick tips for time management is stop multitasking, which will not yield good outcome of any one of those tasks. Set reminders, only focus on what matters. Break tasks into steps, get more organized, remove distractions, plan your day. Not only write down what you need to do, a priority today, but also write down what you should not do. Check your emails only twice a day, not very, very frequently. Have breaks and refresh your mind. So the stress management is very, very important component of lifestyle. And that is very, very essential component in the present day life. And there are 4 A's that one has to understand. Avoid things which you can avoid, which are going to be irritating to you and put you on stress. Alter yourself or a situation if it can be altered. Adopt if it is not alterable or avoidable. Accept things which are neither of 3 A's. And then you can lead a little comfortable, reasonably better health and happy health. And as I mentioned, slow down, keep calm, be positive, take it easy, have fun, enjoy life, unplug, relax, go outside and meditate. And there are so many ways to help you out in if you are stressed, like therapy, spa, music, time management sessions, yoga, meditation, and so on. And these are all the tips for stress management. Art of giving is one thing which we need to learn in this world. We make a living by what we get, and we make a life by what we give. This is one of the quality of lifestyle one has to learn. The joy in giving is part of living. An important message is live for today, be happy. Don't keep on thinking what will happen tomorrow, what will happen if the third wave of COVID comes. Happiness in life is for what we are born to live till the last moment of life and generate happiness. It will have to be generated by you, by your attitude towards others. Hygiene, exercise, sleep, smoking, stopping and moderation of drinking, work ethics and food are going to give you a better lifespan. These are the last 2-3 slides which I'll tell you. These 4 graphs will tell you what has happened from 1960 onward till recent decade. This is Indian graph, the orange one. Red one is China, blue one is Europe, and this is USA. Look, India and China were almost together in 1960s. In China, living life expectancy went far ahead of than us. We are also better than the pre-independence era, but we are not matching with any of those 3 comparable the regions, the geography. Look at this scattered diagram of the lifespan variability across the globe. And there are so many facts for that. Within our state, there are a lot of variations, as it was reported by the census in 2012 to 16. The longer life expectancy is seen in Kerala. The lowest is in Uttar Pradesh, and Karnataka is in between. There are various reasons for these life expectancy changing. Look at this graph on the right upper corner. In 1960s, India and China, life expectancy is something like 43, 44. Look at this, what happened in just 4 to 5 years. The Chinese lifespan expectancy went far away and far better than Indians. Indians improved marginally, went on improving, but never matching with China. So that means there is something not there that we are doing. Average American male life expectancy is 75, whereas Indian 62. Whereas American female expectancy is something like 80, whereas Indian woman is 65, 1.5 decades less than the average American lived. That means there are seriously something wrong with us. And Japanese have the longest lifespan. I'll touch upon this and then close my talk. Japanese have a longer life expectancy. We heard Dr. Maeda, the governor of ACP governor of Japan, talking today morning. He was worried that they are more longer living people with more health problems and less younger people for a loss of this thing. So I read this book, Ikigai. It says about art of staying young while growing old, anti-aging secrets, living longer and better by finding your purpose, how to turn work and free time into spaces of growth, masters of longevity, diet, exercise, resilience. Lastly, we should be having a gratitude and gratefulness expressed to whoever helped you in life. This was a beautiful concept by our Pro-Chancellor. He created a wall of gratitude on the 1st of January this year. We are going to have January 1st, another 15, 20 days from now, where all the employees were asked to come and write their gratitude towards whoever helped them in the last 1 year. So in whole life, we keep thanking people, don't have too much of expectation. Buddha principle, as you know, atiyaseya gati gedu tu. You aspire for more, you fail to live longer. Respect others and appreciate the services. Be happy and live longer. And let us behave properly to live longer with happiness. Thank you all. And I'm sorry, I've taken just 30 seconds more.